Hey, take a look at these words. Murder, assassination, execution. What's the difference between them? Murder, assassination, and execution. Well, they all mean to kill someone. But there's a pretty big difference between these words, okay? Murder is the most general of the three words. It just means to kill someone, okay? Maybe by shooting them, or by stabbing them, or something, okay? We could say, 3 days after leaving the gang, he was murdered. Okay, 3 days after leaving the gang, someone came and shot him, or stabbed him, or something like that, or poisoned. You can also poison someone by putting poison in their food or their drink, and then they die, okay? That's not good. Okay, assassination means to kill someone secretly for political reasons. Okay, both Hillary Clinton and Vladimir Putin have been accused of assassinating their political enemies. I have no idea if it's true, but that's what some people accuse them of, okay? So we could say this sentence here. President Kennedy was assassinated in 1963. I think someone shot him. Okay, but a person could also be assassinated through poisoning. Maybe if you don't like someone, they're your political enemy, you could put some poison into their food or into their beer or something like that. Then when they drink their beer, they're gonna die. Okay, execution. Execution means to kill someone as a punishment for a crime. Okay, so Saddam Hussein was executed in 2006. I'm not exactly sure what his crime was. What was his crime? Maybe crimes against humanity or something like that. I have no idea. If you know what crime Saddam Hussein committed, let me know down there in the comments. I'm not sure. I remember reading it in the news, but I can't think of what he was actually guilty of, what they said he was being executed for. Okay, now execution can also be called capital punishment. Capital punishment. That's sort of the official word for execution. Now, in Canada, we don't have capital punishment. The maximum punishment in Canada is life imprisonment. Okay, so if you murder someone here in Canada, you're not going to die. You're going to be sent to jail for a very long time. That's called life imprisonment. Okay, now, some countries do have capital punishment, okay? And there's different ways that some countries execute people. One form of execution is called electrocution. That's when they put someone in a chair called the electric chair, and they kill them by running electricity, high voltage electricity, through their body until they die. Okay, another form of execution could be lethal injection. Okay, lethal means deadly, and this is an injection here. So they inject some poison into you, and then you die. Okay, another form of capital punishment is hanging. Now, this is very common in the Middle East. Okay, so if you commit a crime in the Middle East, a really serious crime, then they might execute you by hanging. Another form of execution could be the firing squad. Okay, this group of people here with guns, it's called the firing squad. So they all line up and they shoot the person who's guilty of the crime. Okay, that's called death by firing squad. Another way people might execute someone is by putting them in a gas chamber. Okay, the word chamber means room. So they put you in a room and then they fill the room with gas, poisonous gas, until you die. Okay, now I want to teach you a very important word, the word convicted. Convicted means declared guilty. Okay, he was convicted of first degree murder. Okay, that means the judge said you are guilty of first degree murder. Okay, now murder has some different levels. Okay, first degree murder, that's the worst. Okay, that means someone was planning to murder someone. They were planning it, Then they went to their house and they murdered them. Okay, second degree murder is also murder, but it's not planned. Okay, maybe there was a situation where someone just decided to kill someone. Okay, but they didn't plan it beforehand. Okay, that's called second degree murder. And we have another special word called manslaughter. Manslaughter. That's when someone dies, but a person didn't mean to murder them. Okay, let's say me and you get into a fight and you punch me in the face and I die. Okay, you wanted to hurt me, but you didn't want to kill me. Okay, but I died. Then you would be guilty of manslaughter. Okay, now I want to look at the pronunciation of this word. Manslaughter. Slaughter means to kill someone or something. For example, if you want to eat an animal, first you have to slaughter the animal. Okay, now look at this. Man's laughter. Look at the letters here and look at the letters here. They're exactly the same. Okay, but this is man's laughter. Laughter means ha 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 ha, okay? The man's laughter. For example, I could say, I could hear the man's laughter from across the street. Okay, he was laughing very loudly. Okay, man's laughter, it's pronounced like this, laughter with an F. And over here, man slaughter, slaughter. Okay, the two T's sort of go into a flap sound. Man slaughter, slaughter. Okay, I just wanted to show you that. Okay, so I want to know, do you have capital punishment in your country? Let me know in the comments right down there. And hey, if you want to learn more vocabulary on crime and justice, make sure you subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you over in the next episode of Mad English TV. Take care.